We're excited about this program. We're excited to hear what Gary and his group have to present to us today. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce Gary Gillespie.
All right, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Gary Gillespie, and like Brian said, I am with the Biomanufacturing Training and Education Center. We are a training and education center at North Carolina State University, and focused on the area of biopharmaceutical manufacture. And I thought just to start off, before we actually get into the actual presentations, I just wanted to say a few words about training and education in general. And really look at why we need to train and educate, especially professionals, right? How technology and changes in technology are really driving that need for training and education. And just introduce you to the speakers and the talks that you're gonna hear. So when we were thinking about how to start this off, we wanted to answer the question, why do professionals need to be trained and educated? Why do we need to offer those opportunities? And one way to look at this is, if you go to the bottom of that diagram, good business results. That there are many inputs to creating good business results. One of those inputs is certainly outstanding performance on the part of our staff. And there are many attributes that staff should have to really perform in the way that we need them perform to produce those good business results. Some of those include, we want staff that are motivated. We want staff with certain personal traits. We want smart staff. We want flexible staff. We want staff with good interpersonal communication skills. But importantly, we also want staff who have knowledge and skills. And you know, the knowledge and skills doesn't just come along. The knowledge and skills is really developed through good training and education programs. All right, so from this slide, you can see that really we're saying that the knowledge and skills are necessary in order for the good business results. So I would further argue that it's not training and education is not a one-time event. Training and education is certainly a lifelong activity. So for example, when you hire somebody new for us into the biopharmaceutical arena, that person may not have the basic knowledge and concepts that they need to start with. So that person initially may need training and education. But then on top of that, we have changes that are happening in our industry very frequently. Technology changes, regulations change, regulatory expectations change, and then we're moving people around. Our staff may have new job assignments, and those new job assignments may require a different skill set. So we've got changes occurring, and those changes are telling us we really need to be able to provide training and education in a lifelong way. All right, and the particular area that we're focusing on in this forum is new technologies. Companies implement new technologies, and because of that, we need to be putting our staff in a position to use these new technologies. So if we look at this industry, the biopharmaceutical industry, what are some of the new technologies that are really changing the way we do things? And you know, you look at some of the things that are going on. For example, in process development, we're going from doing small-scale studies in process development to doing really small-scale studies, right? Equipment is becoming miniaturized to do process development, and that's sort of one of the trends that's now occurring on the process development side. In manufacturing, we're looking at a number of changes. The big one is really this adoption of single-use technology, so replacing reusable stainless steel with single-use, a big change in technology, and there are several others there that I have listed. In the quality control lab, we're looking at doing single measurements to parallel analysis, looking at ways to go from our regular slow analyses to rapid analysis. And then even on the QA regulatory side, we're looking at converting paper batch records to electronic batch records, and there's technology involved in doing that. So a few points that I want to make here on this slide is, number one is that these technology changes are affecting a variety of roles. It's not just manufacturing, all right? It's process development, it's manufacturing, it's QC, and it's QA. And there are other groups that I could have thrown in there as well. And those changes are affecting all levels, all positions within those roles. It's not just that the manufacturing operator or the QC analyst needs to know what's going on with these new technologies, but even at higher levels. Okay, so these are really cutting across many areas and many different levels of experience and and position within companies. All right, so if we've identified that there is this need for lifelong training and education, what are the resources that are available out there? And this is not a comprehensive list. In fact, it's just a general list of some of the resources that you can turn to for training and education. But you know, most companies have their own internal training programs. And so that's certainly an area. And their role may be very specific to what the company is doing, the processes, the equipment that they're running. And then you have people like me who are training organizations like BTEC, the Biomanufacturing Training and Education Center. And I think our role is we have the opportunity to really train in sort of fundamental aspects of topics and even advanced coverage of topics. And we also have the ability or the opportunity to be very hands-on in our approach to training and education. And then, of course, you have professional societies that are very active in training. They may serve a role similar to training organizations. We have vendors who are manufacturing equipment. They have a niche in training specifically on vendors' equipment. And then we have consultants that can provide training. So there are a lot of resources out there to provide this training and education. And so what we're going to do today for the rest of the time is we're going to hear a series of talks that sort of brings all of these topics, these issues together. So we're going to start off with Chad Cooper from Biogen and David Yarley from Fujifilm Diosynth. And they're both going to talk on the topic of really how do we make training of our employees sort of more fundamental, more foundational? How do we ensure that training is effective? And I would argue that we need this as sort of a launching pad to training on new technologies. Many of these new technologies are extremely complex. Without a good foundation, without good fundamentals, it's going to be very difficult to get our staff going and moving on these new technologies. Then I'll come back up and I'll present a case study on a short course that we put on single-use technology. I'll describe that to you. And then Scott Summer from Rheumatics will come and talk to you about automation training. And automation is certainly one of those technologies that seems to be continuously changing. And so training is certainly needed in the area of automation. And then at the end, we're all going to get together. We'll sit on a panel up here together. You can ask questions to the panel. And Jim Vogel, who was just presenting previously, will lead that panel discussion. All right, so thank you all for being here. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Chad Cooper from Biogen.